Hello guys, as you can see I just placed my new stereo Mabel, and you can also see that the thing is what I scored the day before yesterday. I asked you the question, which of these four things I scored, and the answer is the ohm speakers, my friends. The ohm speakers, unbelievable speakers. What's that? Brand new. Unbelievable, beautiful. Watch this. Yeah, my friends. They don't have wheels. It would be nicer when they had wheels. Let me open the... so you can see what I mean. Pop. This is how they are looking, my friends. Yeah, so I placed the hood back. Beautiful speakers, my friends. And the sound. Believe me, I love my Cantons, you know. I love my Cantons. But I can tell you now that these ohms sound so much better than my Cantons. Yeah, my friends. But that story is for another day. Well, I also scored. Let me show you what I also scored together with this. You will see the scoring video soon. I also scored this Amkron set, the Amkron D158 Series 2. Yes. And this thing is the most expensive thing. This is the Amkron. The SPL2 in very good condition, both are in very good condition. And what they also have, if you have a little bit knowledge about this stuff, is the two cabinets. The two cabinets, only one cabinet is worth on the second-hand market in America, €150. Well guys, I can tell you that in America and in Japan, these, only the preamp without the cabinet, goes away for about 650 to 700 euro, you know, or dollar, that's dollar. And the cabinets, they cost around $160. So the two cabinets would be the price from $320. And I placed them on Dutch eBay, and the maximum bid in 2 days is 400 euro, so that's a ridiculous price, and I want 600 euro for the thing. So for that 600 euro you have that's the price for only, not even the price for only, the preamp, and then you have the two cabinets and the main amp for free. But okay, that's another story. I will test this thing out for you, my friends. And now we go over for the cabinet, because this video goes about the cabinet. I already bought a carpet. The carpet is still upstairs, but I have a problem. I also placed this, as you can see, it is lighted with four of those LED lights. But for the more beauty thing, it should have six, because there are two more glass panels, as you can see, one, two are not lighted. It's more beautiful what it would have. But yeah, the thing I have is only four LED lights. And the thing is, my Akai doesn't fit. Even my Akai AA1175 doesn't fit. My Akai AM93 doesn't fit, because it is too... It's only 12.3 centimeters. And I didn't thought about it when I bought the thing. But yeah, I bought it cheap. I bought it for 150 euro. That was a big joke, my friends. But watch what I did. I placed my television over here. I hardly watch television, so it doesn't matter. Today I watch television because of the football, but normally I... And watch these cables. These cables I pulled out behind... Well, behind this old stereo Mabel, what was standing over here. These cables are not necessary at all. I'm not sure what they were doing over there. But everything is clean now, clean from cables. And I just love this stereo Mabel, you know, just beautiful. I don't think there is a second stereo meuble this beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And that's why I changed my room, just because of this stereo meuble. Because I thought, well, when I'm sitting here, you know, in the morning, taking my breakfast, or my breakfast, my coffee, then I can enjoy this beautiful stereo meuble, you know. Well, that was my plan. And but now, I'm not sure. I have to. I placed the stereo meuble online on second-hand eBay. I have the asking price from 400, because this thing have a much higher value than I paid. And not sure. Well, the thing is, I will not sell it below a certain price, even if the drawers are too. It's not my size. I will not sell it for very cheap, because it is too beautiful to let it go. In the worst case scenario, because I already had my plans, I thought, okay, what would I place on top? I can place a turntable or one of my reel-to-reel decks I have upstairs, that beautiful GX635D. You remember that score? Monster score. I bought that 635D so cheap. Well, I still have it upstairs. I didn't sold it, because some items I don't sell. I mean, items what are rare to score, but I had very cheap, I don't sell, you know. And so I thought, I could place that tape reel-to-reel deck on top, or, well, not sure. And I already thought, okay, one is for my Akai AM93. That one would be over here, yeah, in this corner. Over here, the tuner. Over here, a vintage stereo. And I thought about the Akai AA1175 or the Luxman R1500. But yeah, my friends, they both. What's this, my friends? This is massive, and that's why this thing is far over 1,000 euro. Brand is, if it is new. I just weighed the thing. I didn't weigh it together. I just take one piece of this, because it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces of these pieces, and every of these pieces weight 11.5 kilogram, and then you have the bottom sides with the four wheels. So the thing have a weight from 65 kilo without the drawers. 65 kilo. My friends, this is really a monster of a audio cabinet. But yeah, I can't place my stuff in the cabinet. So that's why I placed online. And well, I'm not sure if I will get the 400 euro, you know, because sometimes, you know, often I lose money if I buy and sell stereo, I have to admit. But with this cabinet, I will not take a loss. If I can sell it above 250 euro, the thing stays in my house. Then I will place the Akai over here, you know, the amplifier I will place on top. And I will find some other items I have upstairs, what can fit in those, in the other parts. You know, the tuner is small. The Akai tuner can come over here. But then I cannot place a tape deck or a turntable on top when that amplifier is on top. That's the problem, you know. That's the dilemma. So I have to see what I have upstairs. Well, no. I don't have nothing upstairs what will fit. I already know most of the things are what I have is way too heavy, way too big for. Well, I just don't have nothing, and that's the problem. That's why I have to sell it. And if not, I will use it with the Akai. I will place the Akai on top. You know, it will still be a nice thing in my stereo room, you know, because I cannot imagine that I can find for below 400 euro or 300 euro a cabinet equal like this. Of course, it will not be equal like this. It will be a completely different cabinet. But what I mean, a cabinet what will make me happy, what have the same. What's this? This is just a I don't know if I never saw a more beautiful cabinet like this one. You know, 65 kilogram, my friends. Pure glass with two pure wooden teak drawers. Beautiful, 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 beautiful. Never saw a thing like this before, because I always watch those. If you compare it with my old stereo cabinet, watch this. This is Spectrum, my friends. You know, the price of this stereo mobile was 400 euro when it was new. I didn't bought the thing new. I bought a thing cheap, 25 euro. I'll be honest with you now. I bought a thing 25 euro, but new price was 400 euro. But in there's no comparison at all with this thing. You know, watch this and watch this. This thing looks just simple. Well, it isn't simple, believe me. The bottom side is from massive wood, you know, that triplex wood. And it is from Spectrum. And Spectrum, it is also on wheels, and Spectrum makes beautiful equipment. And, well, this is more a TV cabinet than a stereo cabinet. Yeah, and that's why I didn't, well, I don't want the thing over there. And this thing is 10 times more beautiful than the other cabinet. And, well, that's why these cabinet. No, I paid 50 euro I paid for this cabinet. Yeah, 50 euro. And the other one I have upstairs, I paid, it's also a Spectral, I paid 25 euro. But for this one, I paid 150. I thought, these people are crazy, selling a thing like this for 150. But I won't let it go under 250 euro. I think even when I have a bid from 250 euro, I won't let it go. Because, you know, for equipment, if I see after a few days, you know, I have a price in my mind, what I paid, you know, with a little profit, you know, let's say a 50 euro profit, and I see, okay, the price what I paid, I don't reach, people don't want to pay that. So, for example, I paid 100 euro for an item, and I place it online for 125, then I see people only bid 75 after a few days. But in a week, I say, okay, I sell it for 75. I take my loss. I take my 25 euro loss. Even when I lose 50 euro, I take my loss. I don't mind, you know. I don't have the patience to wait weeks or months before I sell it, you know. This is how I am. This is how I am. I take my loss very, very fast, you know, because I think, well, I make some money with my YouTube, and that YouTube money can compensate my losses for those losses in audio. And to be honest, my last score, what I scored this stuff, you know, I scored the Gold Moon amplifier, and the Gold Moon, the CD player, the Marantz CD17, Ken Ishiwata CD player, and the what more did I score? The Teal speakers. My friends, you won't believe it, I sold the Teal speakers for 300 euro, because the guy came, you know, he would came for a higher price than the 300, but he came, and the thing was indeed damaged on one side, and because I told Mint, it was Mint, and it wasn't Mint. So, you know, I could argue with the guy, okay, go to your house, I don't want to sell you anymore. But yeah, he was right. I wrote Mint in that ad, and it wasn't Mint. And so those speakers went away for 300 euro. I was lucky. I only had a bid from the Gold Moon, the Gold Moon amplifiers. I had a bid in the Netherlands from 680 euro, but I was lucky to sell that thing for a German guy, a Chinese person who lives in Germany, and I got a price from 850 euro for that Gold Moon. And tonight somebody is coming to pick up the Marantz CD17 for 250 euro. So that means I lose 130 euro, about 130 euro. Let me see, 300, 250, yes, that means I lose about 130 euro for that deal, because I paid 1500 euro for the complete set, you know. So this thing I paid separate, 150 euro, and I think it's a good, beautiful price. So, well, maybe I can make my loss back with selling this thing a little bit more expensive than I paid for it. But we will see. Anyway, I will not sell it for the 150 I paid. I will not sell it because it is too beautiful to let it go for that price. So if I can sell it for 300 euro, you know, then I have my loss back, what I lost on those gold moon and the rest of the equipment. And well, people always ask me, some people ask me, why do you tell the prices what you paid and what you, I normally never tell you the price I sell, because I'm a little bit ashamed sometimes that I sold them, because people always think, well, look at these prices, man, look at these prices, this guy buy everything cheap. But guys, you have to remember that the Netherlands, yes, audio is cheap. It is very cheap in the Netherlands, you know. And if you are smart, if you live in Germany, if you live in Belgium, if you live in Austria or in Denmark, you are smart to sometimes, you know, watch that Dutch eBay to find bargains. There are not enough bargains to find on Dutch eBay. And I think the rest of the world, for example, Japan, I'm not sure which countries, but I mean, that Goldmund amplifier, I almost took the bid from 680 euro. It was the highest bid I got. And then the guy from Germany, he asked me what is the price, and I told him 850. And without argument, he said, okay, I paid that 850 euro. So later I thought, okay, when I if I would told him 1,000 euro, maybe he would also pay, because it is a gold moon, you know, and the gold moons, you know, the value of a gold, the gold moon is just quality. They are one of the best amplifiers ever built, you know. These guys make quality stuff. And, you know, in the Netherlands, they only want to pay 680 euro. That's the thing. The maximum price I would get, if the German guy didn't came up, you know, with his 850 euro, then I would my losses would be much higher, you know. And lucky for me, my loss isn't that big, only still 130 euro, but 120 or 130 euro. I mean, the CD player over here, where is it? Well, anyway, the CD player, the Marantz CD 17 Ken Ishiwata, for 250 euro. It's a big joke. It is a big joke, my friends. These things have a value of normal 500 euro, 400 to 500, you know. And but I calculated wrong. I often calculate wrong, you know, because in my mood, I think, okay, that's a good price. That's a fair price, you know. And then I lose. And in the end, I lose, you know. So this is the thing, my friends. This is the thing. And yeah. That's why I tell you, this cabinet, it doesn't matter even if I can't use it. Well, I can use it, but not in the way it has to be used. It just stay like this. I don't know your opinion, you know, if what I should do. You know, I mean, let's be honest. I cannot even place my Luxman R1500. The plan was Luxman R1500 or Akai AA1175. Both of them won't fit because the room is too small. My Akai AM93 have to go on top. A tuner can fit, and then you have two empty drawers. I'm not sure if I can find, well, probably I have things upstairs what I can fill in, you know, but nothing high end. Well, the Goldmund amplifier is thin enough. The thing is like this. That the gold moon will fit. But yeah, I already sold that thing, and so I'm not sure what to do. Do I keep? I don't think I can ever find a beautiful cabinet. Even if I will sell it for 300 or 400 euro, I don't think I can find for 300 or 400 euro a cabinet like this, because I think a cabinet has to be from glass. Because glass, you can light it like this, you know, the beautiful blue LED light or yellow or red. I can change the colors over there with my remote control. And if six of those drawers were lighted, the effect is even more beautiful. But okay, I have to buy that one. If I keep it, I will buy another LED device. Anyway, I only think that you can have the lighted effect with glass. So glass is for me the number one for stereo cabinets. But okay, you know, because of the, you can make it beautiful with the LEDs, you know, that's what I discovered. And you can also choose for a massive wooden stereo cabinet, but you will miss that light effect. You cannot give a light effect in a wooden stereo cabinet, you know, or any other cabinet from another material, you know. So the only thing what will give an extra dimension on your stereo equipment is, well, let me take out the light. Let me show you what I mean if I turn on off the lights. This is just beautiful, my friends. This is just beautiful, unbelievable, beautiful. How this cabinet is looking, if it is, well, this is light enough, you know. I always have this light on. The spots I only use when I film something in the living room, you know. When I make a video, I never have those spots, these spots. I never use them. Only when I'm filming. And well, my friends, this is it. This is it. This is my dilemma. So I thought, and I bought a carpet. I have the carpet upstairs. So I was busy with my room. I think, okay, I'm gonna place the stereo with my new speakers, you know, the Ohm speakers, beautiful sounding speakers, with my new carpet, you know, and because I need to make some videos, because tomorrow evening, these two modern speakers, they are cheap speakers, I was selling them for 40 euro, you know, somebody's coming to pick them up, and also the CD player, the CD17, somebody will pick them up, and I have now that I have a Marantz SA8003 SA CD player, so super CD player, and that one I want to compare with the Marantz CD17. So that is move video number 3, and I also want to make a separate video from the CD. So I want to make four videos. So I don't have the time. But I thought, okay, I make those 4 videos in my new setup with that carpet, so you have a better acoustic, because I know a lot of you complains about the echo, and that's right, the echo is there, you know, that's why I bought the carpet is upstairs. I thought, let's first do the stereo cabinet, and then I discovered that my stuff won't fit in this cabinet. So if you're gonna buy a cabinet, you know, this is a warning for all of you. If you're going to buy a cabinet, you know, and you think you bought the most beautiful cabinet ever, check out first the size of the... because if you see this, you would think, well, wide enough. But often you won't even think about it, because you see the beautiful cabinet and you think, well, beautiful stereo cabinet, it is built for stereo. So then, obviously, my stereo stuff will fit inside. But in this case, that's not true. That's not the fact. So before you're gonna buy a stereo cabinet, check out first the room. So check out first the height of your highest stereo a piece, for example, your main amplifier, that one is often the the most highest thing in a setup. Check the height of that thing with a centimeter, and if you're gonna buy a stereo cabinet, because I want to spare you the especially if you buy the thing new in the shop. If you buy the thing new in the shop, you can't return it. You can tell the salesman, well, I return it because my main amplifier doesn't fit. This thing won't work, you know. They won't return you the money. That's normal, you know, because that is your mistake. And but okay, I bought it 150 euros, so. But it's not about the money in this case, you know, because if if everything would fit, and you would came to me now, and you would say, I give you 500 for the thing, I wouldn't sell it to you. Because, watch this, my friends, I don't think you can find a more beautiful cabinet like this. I don't think so. You know, I saw many cabinets in my life, believe me, you know. But a cabinet like this is rare. You won't find a second thing. I can't use it. I can't use it, you know. That's the problem. But okay, this was the video. This was a very long video about my new speakers. And I know that a lot of you thought, well, this guy is a cheap guy. He scored the Marantz 6300 because that one was the cheapest from the set. And almost all of you, you know, you had it wrong because, well, the second reason is Ohm, these speakers were never sold in the Netherlands. Never. So the guy who bought these Ohms together with those Amkron amplifiers, he imported them from America, because I know the complete story. The guy imported these speakers from America, and only the import in 1990, only the import, you know, costed him almost 50% extra of the new price in the USA. So he was willing to pay 50% over what normal Americans pay for these speakers when you live in America for the, well, I think even more, because these speakers are very heavy. You have to pay transport costs. This is very expensive. You have to pay your taxes, you know, these things. So the price will almost double if it comes to the Netherlands. And that the guy was willing to pay that. This guy was an audiophile, and also the both amplifiers he imported, and for the reason that they go very good with the combination is very good with these speakers. And I am one of the few in the Netherlands, and maybe in America these speakers are not that rare, you know, and I'm not sure what the price is of these speakers in America. I think about $1,500. But in the Netherlands, it's very hard to say what the price of these speakers. But because these speakers are not sold in the Netherlands, never. You know, if you want these speakers, in that time, you had to import them. That's the only way to buy these speakers if you want these speakers. And because there was no dealership in the Netherlands, you know. And that's why they are very rare in the Netherlands. And I think even in America they are rare. But here they are extra rare. And we will see all these videos from these speakers in the future. And this was the video about stereo cabinet and the things I scored. And thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up if you like this video. And for now I say bye-bye.